You can just tell me your full name.
Okay, my name is Jercina San Miguel Avalos.
My name is Kevin Fernando Granados.
Jasmine Pierres.
Where are you from?
Dominica. My time in Dominica was fun, was more productive since I was working, going to college and all that, maybe on my own, yeah.
What did you study?
Business administration with economics and accounts.
Yeah. And when did you come to London?
In July 2017.
Yeah. Why did you come?
To better my life, of course.
Yeah.
And my mom gave me the opportunity, so I had to take it.
And, yes. I think it's everything.
So your other job is very late in the evening that you start?
It's 7 to 9.
Okay.
7 to 9. I'm born in Bolivia. Yeah.
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 So what did you study there in Bolivia?
Well, I finished the higher school and then I started studying for secretary. And finished there that. I'm trying to enter to the university.
So what did you qualify in when you was in Bolivia?
Well, just for secretary. I'm finished and have all the levels there. Yeah.
So what made you decide that you wanted to come here?
It was not like, it was just because I want to know. I want to meet how is London, how is, because is the my family said, or my mother said to me, you want to go somewhere, it's another country, and I said, I pick up London because it was, I know you can be different, but here it's like to start from new, from everything, so I decided to come to London.
Yeah.
You can speak in Spanish.
Bueno, para una oportunidad de trabajo.
Mm-hmm. What did you work as in your country?
tuve dos empleos por tres largos años dedicados siempre a sobre mi carrera. Dedicado a lo que es la agricultura y la ganadería de mi país.
Mm-hmm.
Yo soy de Honduras, América. Soy ingeniero agrónomo.
I expect everything to be easier. Knowing that I could just get a job like that, I expect all that to be easy on me. Yeah, especially my qualifications. I expect a better job even. Yeah, better pay. I was at everything downhill because I realized I would have to do everything over again. They were asking me for everything over, which I think it was unfair because I had to repeat my studies. I did 3 years and that would be unfair. Let's remember the money that I paid into my education, my time spent into my education, and that is like, to me, I just find it like my age would be past that. And I'm getting older. Of course, I want to go into something else, something higher. It wasn't making sense. And to me, it's like I spent so much effort into putting what I thought would be better for me. And now, when I come here, there's nothing to repeat.
What would your advice be to someone who is thinking about coming to England?
Well, first, if they have the chance to learn English in their countries, can do it.
My advice would be think twice. No. Where you come from, know where you want to go. I think you should seek information for yourself, think what's best for you and what situation you'll be putting yourself into.
Hello, who's that?
Mila.
You hear yourself?
Yeah.
How cool's that? Let's pass it back.
What job would you like when you're older?
Mama.
A mummy. And would you like to be like I am?
Yeah.
Or even better?
Better.
And how would you be even better? What's that?
Starts with a K.
Oh, you tell us. Oh, so you do cooking?
Yeah.
Baking?
Yeah.
Oh, mummy not very good at baking.
No.
Who baked... Have you broken that? Who baked your birthday cake?
You!
And where's mummy been going to a lot?
Cancer club. Kissy got the lemon. Kissy got the lemon.
When she met your dad, she was so happy, you know. She obviously had found the right man, you know, when you were born and Rowan was born. And when she was huge, expecting you. Yeah, she was so happy.
Your mum loved Christmas. So is Christmas hard? Yes, of course it is. Up until this year, I've massively struggled putting Christmas decorations out, which I want to do because your mum made them. But even last year, I was crying the whole way doing it. We went shopping in Oakhampton, but your mum said her it was so bad that she just wanted to sit in the car, so she sat in the car. And then we came back, and on the Saturday, she said, like, it's just getting unbearable. So we took mum to hospital. They scanned her head, and they found a tumour. Right in the middle of her brain. And it was the size of a golf ball.